Hi and welcome to Cakes and Conversations, and today we're going to learn how to make sponge toffee, honeycomb, or you can say the Cadbury crunchy bars. And to begin with, we have liquid glucose or corn syrup, whatever is available with you, you can take that. A little bit of honey just for a mellowy honey flavor. Water, sugar, baking soda, cream of tartar, and the tools that you need is the mixing tool, temperature thermometer. These are infrared thermometers specifically for candy, not the body temperature ones, because the body temperature one has a maximum range of around, I think, 56 or something. These are specifically for candy, which can go higher up to 380 centigrades or 716 F, if you see here. So before you purchase, always check that. The range, minimum and the maximum range. A strainer, 1 teaspoon measurement spoon, and I have a lined silicone tray, you can say, for the bars, because I'm doing the crunchy bars. I have just oiled them a little bit, like very, very less oil, maybe like a fingertip, and I've just wrapped it through because I'm going to pour my sponge toffee in this, and then we're going to make the Cadbury crunchy bars. And if you don't want to go with the bars, you can still make the sponge toffee or honeycomb for your desserts, for your cakes. It's equally delicious as it is. Make sure that it is being stored in airtight containers, because sponge toffee or any kind of sugar absorbs moisture and becomes very sticky. So now let's just begin. I'm going to take my saucepan. There is already liquid glucose in it. Measurements of everything I'll be mentioning in the description. I'm going to add a little water. Sugar. That's it. This is the only three ingredients that we start with. So while this is cooking and this reaches to a degree of 140 Celsius, we are going to do not stir it, not more than maximum once. I'm not going to stir this anymore because this increases the crystallization of the sugars. I'm not going to stir this at this moment. When I see that it's starting to boil is when I will just give one stir, and that's enough. We will check the temperature now. The temperature is 22 degrees. We need to reach up to 140 degrees, and then we would add honey to it. Okay, till then, this is gonna stay as is on the stove. So now at this stage, it's already reached to 136 degrees Celsius. If you see, the bubbling is very slow and the liquid has become very thick. It's not going to caramelize, but this is just going to give me a little amber color. Okay, now I'm adding honey to it just for the taste. It's up to you. You can completely omit this honey if you do not want to add it. And now we just mix lightly. I'm gonna wait till it reaches 150 degrees. Once it reaches 150 degrees, we're gonna take it off the flame, and we work fast at this stage. That is why I'm explaining it to you prior. This is baking soda. This toffee is using up a lot of baking soda because it has to bubble up. I'm using cream of tartar because cream of tartar will ensure that the bubbles are formed evenly. So now we're gonna strain. If you see, some of the baking powders and baking soda have lumps in it. So that is the only reason we're gonna strain it over this. It's already reached the temperature. Switch off the flame. Very carefully, you're dealing with sugar. Do not let kids come when this is being prepared. Keep it on the side. soon as you mix it, you know that it's going to bubble up very bad. So take a deep bottom saucepan. Now you need to pour it in the lined tin, but just halfway, because it's going to increase a lot. It's okay if it is not poured in evenly, it's fine. We can just do it with a knife later. If you're not doing it in a silicone pan, please use aluminium pans and line it with a parchment paper for easy removal and demolding. Whatever gets stuck, no problem. Please do not touch it with your bare hands. We can break it always later. This is sugar that you're dealing with. And it will set up immediately. So it's okay if it's a bit uneven, because you need to work very fast. We just needed small portions so that we can dip it in a chocolate to make the toffee, to make the crunchy bar. And allow this to set up at room temperature for 2 hours, and then we will dip them in chocolate. I'll demold and show you how the next step is done. So after an hour, my toffee has been set, but if you do a tray bake, it will take you 2 hours. It easily demolds from the silicone pan. It's quite light, it's not very heavy, and if you see here the hollow sound. Okay, this is how your sponge toffee it should be. Do not worry that if it is not even, that's okay. We can anyway, you know, take off those ends and use it in our other desserts. It's tasty even if you eat it raw. You can always also use a grater to, you know, grate the side so that it's even. But that's how it's gonna be. It does sink a little bit. So if you want, you can use a grater to, you know, straighten up the edges. It's gonna have the shiny finish because of the sugars. Okay, it's gonna be sticky in some while. So make sure that once it has been set up, quickly either you dip it in chocolate so that you enclose the sugar, so that the moisture doesn't get exposed. I mean, it doesn't get exposed to moisture. Or you will keep them in an airtight container. Okay, I'm gonna break one apart and show you how it looks from inside. That's the sponge toffee or the sugar honeycomb that we were talking about, and we will be coating this in chocolate. So if you see, I've broken down pieces and I will be using it for my ice creams or other desserts. Okay, and I've demolded the bars and I've kept it in an airtight container. I'm okay if they are different sizes, because this sets up faster, so I don't want to spoil it. The only thing I did is that, you know, I just grated all the edges with the grater. So if you see, I've just grated all the edges, and this was the only one that I got a full one from the mold, which is quite thick and nice. And this also is great, but these ones are quite thin, which is okay, because I'm going to join two like this and make a bar, which is completely okay. So I'll show you how to do that next. But till that, I'm going to keep it in an airtight container, because I don't want to expose it to air, as it's already getting sticky. These also, you can immediately use it to your cakes or ice creams or anything. If you're not using it, again, keep them in airtight container or in Ziploc bags where you can do a vacuum sealing, okay? So now we're going to dip the sponge toffee or the honeycomb bars that we prepared into chocolate, and we're going to set like bars. And I'm just going to prepare a few. I also had this mold from ages. It is a sneaker bar mold, which I have never used. Let me try in this also. I'm not sure if I could make it in this or no. But first I'm going to dip it, I'm going to dip it into chocolate. Your chocolate has to be melted but not too warm or hot or anything. It should be a little thick and nice and flowy. Plus it should be cool to touch. Like when you touch, it should not feel hot. Okay, so now we're going to take the big bar that I had, the full portion that I got. I'm going to just dip it in chocolate. The chocolate will help seal the moisture. I mean, basically seal the toffee so that the air does not get in contact with it and it seals in the crunchiness. Because if you keep this outside, basically it will become moist, soggy, soft. So this is the best way to seal in the moisture or seal in the toffee, the crunchiness. You can use two forks or you can use one, that's your choice. Just take the excess off and allow it to set. Similarly, you will do it for all of it. Also, if you don't want this setting falling, the chocolate falling on the sides like this, I'll just show it to you. Okay, then you can chill your tray first in the freezer so that as soon as you put it on it and the chocolate will set, it will not drip off. Okay, now we'll try to do it in this particular mold. I'm going to tap all the air bubbles. This is mandatory because otherwise you will have all air bubbles or air pockets down on the finished product. Okay, I'm gonna keep the thin bar because I don't know if the height is perfect for this or no. Okay, yes. Fortunately, the mold is exactly the size that I'm looking, I mean my bar size. I'm gonna take a little bit of this and push it in that. And what air bubbles I was talking about is if you don't tap it in the mold, you will see these air bubbles. If you see this air bubble, okay, this comes in. So it's better to always tap it in the mold. Now, once I'm keeping this in the fridge for like say 10 minutes, and then I will demold this and clean the edges and I'll show it to you. All right, so after 10 minutes, they're already out of the fridge and I was already taking up the excess. I've done these two bars. For this one, I thought I'd like to show you how you do it. It's just to neaten up, okay? Because see, everyone knows homemade would not be very perfect like how machines would do it. But still, if you wanted something neater, just go ahead and, you know, just do it like this. From all the sides. So now if you see the edges, I've smoothened up all the edges from the chocolates. Similarly, I will be doing it for this one. If your chocolate is well set, it will automatically come out from the mold without any difficulty. Now you see, if I've straightened the edges, it looks like a proper bar from a chocolate shop. Okay, so this is how it's gonna look like, and then you can go ahead and always pack it up or wrap it up as per your style what you want. I'll just cut one and show you. I'm gonna cut the thick one. I wanted to show you that the chocolate layer or the coating is quite thin so that it just balances the taste. And trust me, it is exactly same like the Cadbury Crunchies that we get in the supermarket. So go ahead and try it out. Let me know, post comments in the below if you've already done that, if you tried this recipe out. Let me know how did you like it and what you would like to see next. All right, till then, it's Subscribe for more. Thank you so much for watching.